Hi there and welcome to our week-ending episode of Hoohaa Sports Today. And what a couple of weeks it has been for Malaysian football fans with Arsenal, Liverpool and just last night, Chelsea came, made their presence felt and left us with memories to last a lifetime. Having said that, not all would have been sweet. But yesterday's friendly with Malaysia, Chelsea were poor in all departments. All their stars failed to shine, except for maybe Didier Drogba, John Obi Mikel and Daniel Sturridge. And as we all know, the final scoreline was decided by a fortuitous goal, which all of us who are fortunate to have seen the replay will say it wasn't a goal. The only unfortunate few would have been the referee and his assistant who ruled that the ball did cross the line. The bright side of it, the Malaysian Cubs or Harimau Muda did very much indeed give a good account of themselves, which I'm sure most fans are sincerely proud of their efforts. But the dubious goals wasn't the only talking point. The 70,000 that turned up at the National Stadium were constantly booing Yossi Ben Ayun, who played in the first 45. He's the first Israeli to play in Malaysia, and if you're not informed, Malaysia does not have diplomatic ties with Israel and is a staunch supporter of the Palestinian cause. The foreign media gave it much focus on their report in the match report. But besides that, we looked at the official Chelsea Facebook page to see what the global fan base are saying. They're not too pleased and are pushing for Abramovich to open his vault to spend, spend, spend. Most know where the weakness lies. They're aging players and they know the Blues are still far from competing with Barcelona. Well, all the excitement with the Premier League Asia Tours. Now focus will be on Malaysia's World Cup qualifier with Singapore this weekend. Here's our exclusive interview with Malaysian legend Datuk Soh Chin Aun and his opinion on our lads. Enjoy that video and we'll catch up with you on Monday. Till then, from the team and I, it's bye for now.
And I think there's no harm, lah, but provided we have a strong side, you know, to match a strong team in European soil or in even in the Middle East. That's how I look at it. Is it? So exposure is a good thing, but provided we have a good team, we have a real strong team, and we need good exposure.
And we need to learn from this.
Then only we can learn something. If we can't even beat the local team here and our team is weak, we don't have a strong committed players, then there's no point for us to go overseas for exposure. It's only when we have good team, we can't find good opponent here to match us, then we need to go for exposure.
So do you have, you know, the slightest wish that, you know, the Malaysian team can qualify for the Olympics and fulfill the dream that, you know, you almost stepped into it?
Well, I would very much like to see them qualify for the Olympics or even the World Cup, you know. But it's going to be very tough, especially I think we have to understand my time is different. You know, we play in the qualifying round in what they call Carnival. Is a carnival thing, a tournament, you know, where you play in a small tournament to qualify. But whereas now you have to, play for the qualifying round. It's a knockout game. Unless you win, otherwise you'll be knocked out, you have no chance. But whereas in a carnival tournament like those days, if you lose one game, you may still have a chance for this kind of thing. You know? So it's going to be very tough for them. But we must give them a chance. But we should not be too disappointed if we don't win.